Avocado trees present an interesting problem. Crop yields year to year vary massively. Having high yields one year, saturating markets and therefore dropping the price of a fruit. Other years, we may get nothing from a tree. We call this irregular bearing.
Irregular bearing creates headaches all the way along the supply chain, right from growers and packhouses and exporters. So managing heavy volumes of fruit right through to low volumes is a big challenge.
It's generally driven by initially environmental factors. So we may have a nicely balanced tree and then we might get a frost leading to poor fruit set. Of course, if we've got poor fruit set, we've got a lot of resource available for vegetative growth, producing a lot of flowers the following year, and off we go into a spiral. So at Plant and Food Research, alongside New Zealand Avocado, we've just been looking at ways to mitigate this problem. And one of the things that we found is by removing crop load, taking out branches with flowers and fruit on them, especially early on, we can balance these trees to promote flowering the following year. So here we've got an example of a very heavily flowering branch. You can see that there's absolutely no vegetative growth coming from the tips, and there's no vegetative growth at this stage coming from behind the flowers. So if this sets fruit, there'll be no growth to set flowers next year, and there's no vegetative growth over the top of it. So those fruit are going to get sunburnt this year and actually end up with reject avocados. So if I was a grower, this would be a good branch to get rid of. Back in here, we'd remove this entire branch, and what we would expect through the coming spring is a nice bit of vegetative growth to come out from the base.
If we could improve our productivity and the consistency of production, it would be much stronger industry and more robust industry for our growers in terms of the financial returns and financial predictability from one season to another. But that flows through right the infrastructure of the industry, the packhouses seem more confident to invest, and also developing markets and customers in our export markets would be a lot easier if we've got a consistent high production year to year basically.
So if we can get the right balance of vegetative growth in spring with flowers, we can start to balance the tree again. And we've been able to show that flower pruning before fruit set works and actually increases the profitability of an orchard. So not only we say we're looking at yields, but we're actually looking at the profitability of doing this and what it looks like long-term.